I'm going to do something a little different this time and walk you through my workflow for reconstructing the ulna from Patriofelis, this specimen that I had. So basically what I had in this fossil that I've been working on is part of the right ulna that was in very good shape. So if I zoom in here and look around, you can see there's really no breaks on it. But I only have part of it. I don't have the lower end of it. On the other hand, I have almost the complete left ulna, but it's broken into these three chunks, and I've got a chunk missing right here, and then this big chunk missing out the back. So basically, I'm going to combine these in Blender into one single complete bone. So all of these scans were cleaned prior to importing into Blender because you can't really do a good job of getting rid of non-manifold edges in Blender. So I put them through like Mesh Lab and made sure there was no holes and no non-manifold geometry. So you can see I'm importing them by going to File, Import, and then STL. And as I import each one, I set the origin to the center of the object. So I do that by just having the object selected and then going to Object, Set Origin, Geometry to Origin, like you see there. Okay, now I'm starting to spread them out. And so I've got now all four elements imported in. And what I'm going to have to start doing is repositioning them so that they are aligned as they fit together. So I start by using the move and rotate tools to get the three pieces from the left ulna all put together in the position that they're supposed to be. Once I lined up all the elements from the left ulna, I mirrored the right ulna and overlapped it. So I forgot to record that part, so I'm just showing here. You can go to Object, Mirror, and then I did it over Y Global to mirror the entire thing across the Y axis. If you mirror it across other axes, it'll just flip it, but you can always turn it back. So it doesn't really matter too much. And now you can see how I can overlap now the left ulna, or I should say the right ulna over the left ulna. So kind of using the two overlapping as a guideline. And it's really just about matching your eye, how close it is. All right, now going back to that original lineup, you can see I've got the mirrored right ulna overlapping with the left ulna, and I'll rotate it back and forth here so that you can actually see how these two are overlapping. Now that I've got everything lined up, I can turn off the top of the left ulna because I'm going to be using the right ulna instead. And I'm going to start stitching these meshes together. So one thing I realized, even though I had already done cleaning, was that these meshes were way too dense to stitch together really easily. So what I'm doing right now is I'm decimating each of the meshes individually. And the first thing I did was go into wireframe mode in the upper right, just to be able to see kind of what the density of the mesh was. And then I'm adding a decimate modifier to the each of the meshes. So I do that by selecting the mesh in object mode, and then in that properties window there's the little wrench, which is the modifiers, and I'll probably do a video on modifiers at some point, but they can do all sorts of cool things. I'm just adding a decimate modifier there. And so once I've added this, it has a bunch of different options, and I'm honestly just kind of playing around with the percentage I want to decimate by, just seeing, eyeballing how it looks, and then also the type of decimation that works. I ended up landing on this collapse type that seemed to just be working best for the shape of the mesh I had, and then I had to decimate down to almost like 20 or 25%. And once I start actually stitching these meshes together, you'll see why that was so useful. Now I want to join all of these meshes together so that they are all the same and I can edit them all together at the same time. So I control select them and then I go up to object join. And once I've done this, they're all part of the same mesh, even though they're not actually stitched together yet. So that way, when I go into edit mode, in this particular case, working on the edges, I can select both at the same time. So what I'm doing right now is just selecting the edges and then deleting them where the breaks are in the mesh. You'll notice, though, I actually made a mistake joining them together ahead of time because I realized that I can't just delete one part of the middle and not the other. So I needed to have left those separate meshes. So you're going to see me undo all my work here so that these aren't joined meshes anymore, then select just the middle mesh and go into edit mode on that and delete everything on that that doesn't match, that is overlapping with the middle part. So I'll just speed through this as I select each mesh, go into edit mode, and then delete the ends of the bone so that I can stitch together these cracks. Adjusting a little bit of the decimation there. And then once I have all of these ends deleted, and they're basically just like cylinders that I can connect together, that's when I can start joining the meshes like I had done previously. So selecting these three separate meshes, going to object, and then selecting join. So once I've done that, I can go into edit mode and edit the entire mesh at once. And to bridge the gaps here, I'm going to need to specifically be in edge mode. And then I can go to edge and bridge edge loops. So I need to select the edges I'm going to do for that. So I'm just picking two that seem like they'll bridge cleanly right next to each other. And shift click to get that. And then I go back up to edge and click bridge edge loops and you'll see that nice bridge appear. So I'm going to repeat this all the way around to basically capture the curvature around this gap. And then I can go back in and fill all the holes where there's not tons of curvature happening. And that'll just keep the filling hole geometry from getting all funky. And as I do this, you'll see I might accidentally select the wrong edges. I might pop into face mode and delete some faces that are giving me problems, try and smooth out the borders. So it's kind of a back and forth process. Once I've bridged this gap all the way around, I can start filling these holes. And I do that by selecting the edge of a hole in edge mode all the way around by double clicking on one of the edges. And you'll notice there I actually had to go into face mode and delete some of the jagged faces that were sticking out because they were preventing Blender from recognizing that that was a closed hole that I was double clicking on. So once I am able to double click on it, I can go to face and then fill. And that will fill the hole with some relatively rough polygons, but we can smooth those out later. All right, now I just need to go around and repeat this process in all of the holes I've created, maybe cleaning up some faces here and there. And then, of course, I'll need to repeat the whole process on the bottom crack. But once I've done that, basically these will be connected into one mesh, and all I'll have left to do is smooth out these kind of rough-looking polygons that are here. So I pop over to the sculpting tab and I select the smooth sculpting tool. And at first it was way too strong, so I just tweaked the strength a little bit. And this allowed me to basically smooth out those really large polygons and get them to mesh better with the smaller polygons. So I wasn't actually completely done at this moment. You might notice the shading at the boundary looks pretty funky, and it turns out that's actually because I had flipped the normals, basically meaning the top part of the mesh was inside out relative to the bottom part. So you can visualize this by going to the viewport options in the upper right, which are the two circles overlapping, and then checking face orientation. Unfortunately, I didn't show how to actually do this, but you can see what it looks like, where red are the inside-out faces and blue are what is supposed to be on the outside. So this turned out to be a fairly easy fix. Just go to edit mode, select all with Control A, and then go to mesh, normals, recalculate outside, and it'll fix all of that issues automatically. So this is what it'll look like in face orientation if all the normals are facing outward the correct way. So in the end, I was able to get this nice put together mesh of Patriofelis ulna.